Estamos en Barcelona, vamos a pasar el control de seguridad normal y casi siempre podéis ver que pone feel safe, no pasa absolutamente nada. Estos son los carretes que tenemos, un par de blanco y negro. Nunca lo hemos probado en blanco y negro y no sé si afecta tanto, así que será interesante. Tenemos un Ultramax, un Porter 360 y un Porter 400. Sara va a estar disparando con esto, el behind the scenes. Intentaremos hacer fotos paralelas y habrá uno de los dos carretes que dispararemos después. Y ya está, y veremos a ver qué pasa. ¿Dónde comemos?
Two hours later.
Ya estamos aquí, detrás mío están los escáneres. Ya tenemos los dos carretes disparados. Separaremos el de la bolsa de plomo.
Sí.
This is gonna be very close to react to what happens when you send your film through the X-ray scans and more importantly through the CT scan. We already had two jobs from clients that sent to the lab and they told us, hey, there's something wrong with the scans, I don't know, like the color is super off. The thing was, we discovered they run through these new CT scanners in the US and it was a huge mess. Basically, it killed all the shadows, it looked a bit off, like dull. And we knew that in Amsterdam they were installed very recently. So I said, okay, let's book a trip to Amsterdam. The reason why we've done this is basically because nobody's done it. So we decided to do it ourselves. Here I have two rolls where we exposed during in Amsterdam and then we run through the scanner. Another roll that it was completely blank and run through the scanner. And these are black and white rolls that I'm gonna show you in the screen. Et voila! We have aftershot, pre-shot. First, it was a CDX. This is the film we spool, which is super cool branding. I can show, it's a little promotion. Sara doesn't know, but it's okay, I will do it anyway. This is the new packaging of the Double X. It looks fucking amazing, it feels even better. Inside is our fresh re-spooled Double X. It's black and white film for cinema. So in the CDX, I think the grain is a bit strange. It's not the usual grain of the CDX. This is a bit weird. It's not that grainy. It feels like there is a kind of a layer underneath that of grain. So in the highlights, it doesn't feel that much, but in the shadows, you can really see it's way too grainy. It is not like this usually. There is some specks in here, which I'm suspecting. This is with a compact camera. It's just, it looks a bit weird. I would not say the film is ruined, but it looks a bit off. Like the whole sky is a bit strange. The conclusion is it looks a bit off, but it's nothing major. Let's go for the Tri-X. This is a whole roll of Tri-X that we just ran through the scanner and we shot entirely in Valencia afterwards. This is Natasha putting, yeah. Not now because everybody is home except me and Sara. Here is a bit the same pattern. It feels the same, kind of a bit flat. It's kind of you put a gray filter on top of it. This is interesting. Try to do a bracketing because what I was suspecting is that whatever rays may affect this, it will be more noticeable on the underexposed films. When you overexpose, you add extra light into the emulsion. Basically, you add more information. So whatever happened there that is a bit messy, if you override it with a ton of light, it will probably fix it up. Usually, Tri-X has a lot more latitude into it, or flexibility into it in the mid-range. Especially plus one or zero, I think it performs quite okay. This feels like the trash cans are talking to each other. That's why I take the shit. Conclusion is like, this is not something I would just throw in the trash. If it would be my recommendation, in black and white, you're safe. Just overexpose a little bit. Try to give it a hand check if you can. So this is for the black and white. Now let's move into the color. We have one with the film that I shot afterwards and two films that we shot in Amsterdam. One we put in a Domke bag, which is the lead bag that protects from blocks any kind of radiation. They stopped it, of course.
I have a lead bag for film. I don't know if it looks completely dark.
Not completely.
Oh, not completely, okay.
So this is the bag.
You can see inside.
Yeah.
Wow.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. You could see there was some kind of shape
I was like, can you see what's inside? And he's like, a little bit, you know, I mean, I guess if there is a knife or something, he can see there is a knife. I was like, holy shit, if he can see there is a film inside, that means it's blasting x-rays. Then there was another one. I just left it in the camera and ran it through. Let's check the donkey bag first. Probably the ones everybody's more curious, even the donkey guys. This looks pretty fine to me, to be honest. This is the sharpness from the Frontier. What is interesting is I'm not seeing any strange noise in the darker side. This image feels a bit grainy, but it's a bit underexposed, and I think it's pretty fine. I don't see anything off. These are completely raw, straight from the scanner. The color looks nice, the contrast looks nice. Even I flip this to see, there is nothing major. The grain doesn't really bother me at all. This was absolutely underexposed, but this is the properly exposed. But this is very interesting because if there would be any traces of x-rays or something messy, it will pop up here, and it's totally fine. The donkey bag did an amazing job, to be honest. This is amazing, this turnout, like, I love this light. So donkey bag passed the test. For me, I would say nothing happened to this film at all. I would recommend it. And now, let's see what happened to the one that had no protection, no lead back, just in the camera and just run through the scanner. Poor camera, poor camera. Anyway, this is a little bit underexposed, but this is super weird. This is not normal at all. Like Portra 160 doesn't do this. I don't know how to explain this texture. It's kind of a paper texture. It resembles to me like the noise we saw in the scanner. It was kind of this like white noise. And it's funny because it looks much harder on this part of the image than this part of the image. I don't know why. It's also possible that the scan it doesn't act on the whole roll the same way. But this is crazy. We are starting to see strange things here. Okay, check. Probably this exposure was not the same as the other exposure. It's very likely. But nevertheless, it should not affect the darker part. Okay, for example, in these two images, I'm just looking at the corner. So even if I push the exposure like crazy, this is basically pitch black. And this image, it's just like complete madness. We are starting to see some results. Donkey one, no donkey, zero. Same here, in one edge, you can almost not see it so much. In the other, it's very visible. These traces, like these textures, are not normal at all. This is completely the effect of the CT scan. Which, remember, we could not see this with the donkey bag. Even in this, we can really see, there is kind of this bluish. This is kind of normal, to be honest, but not this kind of image. The thing is, I have the feeling that the CT scan adds kind of a small layer of noise and kind of probably color shifting into the image. So it modifies how the image is written into. If we overwrite it with a ton of information, this layer basically disappears. So at the moment, what we are seeing is underexposed images look like shit. Overexposed images look quite fine. This is awesome, to be honest. It's a horrible beer, but makes for a nice picture. I had the feeling from what we've seen in the lab that on the highlights it's not so bad, but on the shadows is where it really shines in the bad way. If we compare it to the one we had with Donkey, for example, you can see these areas where, you know, like black pants. It's crazy. And then there was the Portra 400, which I shot afterwards. This is the example we've seen in both cases with process film, because people shoot the film and ship it to us. So what we see is people that bought the film, went through the scanner, shot it and sent it through us. I believe this is a bit of the worst case scenario. Basically, you've burned the film before exposing it. So this will make the emulsion probably a bit more dull and probably losing a bit of sensibility. This doesn't look horrible, but to be Portra 400, this feels more like C200, Fuji C200 to me. This noise is not normal. You can see, right? Also, the color is a bit weird. It's a bit faded. You can see there is a lot of grain and it's very messy. Then I said, okay, let's change the values. And boom, crazy. Of course, it's the same film through the same scanner, through everything. You can see the difference. It's just one frame after the other. The color is absolutely different and the grain is absolutely different. It looks a bit strange, but it's something it would be very hard for me to tell. Conclusions. If you need to pass through the scanners and you don't have a dome kebab, overexpose. It will save you a ton of problems. Like, again, I'm not a big fan of my face, but you can see what happens. If you're underexposed and you have x-rays, this is what's gonna happen. This is also what's gonna happen. In the car, it's the same. The noise in it, it's very different. Any defect that the film may have, it's always gonna show up in the shadows. The biggest conclusion is, if you can, use a dome kebab. If you cannot, just overexposed. Be aware from how many scans you go through. We will put again the comparison. You will see the amount of radiation. Of course, this is not absolutely scientific, but it's the best we could do with the resources and the time we had. We were almost not doing it. We were thinking about this for a few months, but then we get more questions. We see things, people talking about this. And at some point we decided, okay, fuck it, we will do it ourselves. I hope this helps. We will publish all this information in a blog post. So you go through CT scans, it's not the end of the world, but just try to avoid it and happy shooting. What a week.